So let's talk about now, how would you identify the potential role a conversational AI may take in the enterprise? Large scale, mid-scale, doesn't matter. But let's talk about the business. Conversational AI is very interesting, actually, because it has a few very distinct type of roles it can take that map to the way an organization is typically structured. Most of us immediately think about conversational AI taking on the role of customer service agent, because we all have a call center and we all have customer service agents. Very relevant, obviously. Making it a part of your, if you're a bank, your branch, or making it, if you're a dentist's office, making your appointment management system, talking to somebody coming in who wants to arrange their appointment. Any type of customer interaction for the common inquiries they interact or reach out about, it's obviously a very important role and something that we see very big adoption in, very successful. This typically is a customer facing role in the business. There are, however, two other very interesting roles. The second one is actually, we commonly see, is an employee concierge. Imagine you are an employee of a big firm. How many different internal contact centers or points of contact are there to get something done? From your first day onboarding to moving on to your new remote desktop, you have a problem with your Outlook, your password got locked, and by the way, everybody gets their password locked. Or any other common issue you may have, you have a compliance question, you have a regulatory question, where do you go? Could you have a employee concierge in the enterprise that you can engage, speak with, and have your questions answered as a single point, or help you go to where you need in the enterprise? It is a similar role to a customer-facing one, but now you're facing the employees, and it's typically a very in-depth experience handling a variety of common things people contact the enterprise about. And this can be relevant to you as an HR manager, as a manager in finance, or somebody who's doing the IT help desk. Ideally, you can think of it as one employee concierge across those roles. The third one is very interesting. It's a whisper agent. What is a whisper agent? In some businesses, the customer-facing contact is a highly skilled, specialized labor, not somebody you would replace with conversational AI. It's not a contact center agent, but it is, for example, a wealth advisor for a wealth management firm, or it's an insurance agent, or it's a doctor, right? These are people you are not going to replace with conversational AI. But could you make those experts more effective by empowering them with a whisper agent that's in their pocket that helps them do their job more effectively? Because you don't want your doctor spending all his time doing logistics. You don't want your wealth manager spending all his time just working internal systems. You want them engaged with the patient, engaged with the customer. Can they have a virtual assistant, a conversational AI, that helps them do all the things around their work, around their role? So that introduces conversational AI to domains where you typically wouldn't have a contact center at all, but instead it's a whisper agent helping the expert in the field. I hope this helps you apply or identify how you may apply conversational AI in your business, in your enterprise. There you'll find, most likely, there's quite a few more opportunities than you thought starting.